guys, it's Huff. I am back again. This is going to be part three of my purples comparison from my massive purple collection. I have a whole bunch of pairs to do today and one group of four. So let's just get into it with a nice pinky kind of purple. I have these two here. So this one here from Ultra 3 is called Purple Passion. Excuse the messy looking bottle. And this one from Sally Hansen's Insta-Dry line is called Instant Iris. So Purple Passion. I think it's funny this is called Purple Passion because it's actually quite pink. A lot of people would have probably put this in their pink section. Not a lot of people. So that is the first coat of Purple Passion. And this one is Instant Iris. I quite like the Insta-Dry line, but their shimmery ones are not the best. So on the first coat, they do look pretty similar. More formulation difference than anything else. Most of the Instant Dry ones, like the cream ones, you can do in one coat. With the shimmery ones, you need two. You can't get past it. Next, I have two kind of weird looking purple ones. This one's super duper old. Bet you haven't seen one of them bottles in a while. This is one of Maybelline's Express Finish from years and years ago. This is called Plum Motion. And this one is from Designer Brands, which is an Aussie kind of brand. This is called Opal Purple. And they both kind of are like these browny purples with a shift to them. Although I think this one's shift is a lot more purple than this one's. So we will start with the Maybelline. Reach for such an old polish. Whoops, made a mess. It still has a great formula. It goes on so easily. It's got a little bit of a stink to it. I'm pretty sure it always had that little bit of a stink to it though. Because you know, that was in the days before all the 3-free, 5-free. Whatever. So the brush is so different, and the formula is so different. Color wise, they're not that different, but formula wise and brush wise, the brush on the Maybelline one is so much nicer. The Maybelline has got more of a pinky red shift than the purpley shift of the Designer Brands one. Next, we have two that are color-wise quite similar, but they will have a slightly different finish because they've got different finishes. This one here is from W7. This is from their Suede Effect line. This is Mauve Suede, and I'm going to compare it to Harmony from China Glaze. I'll start with the W7. If you did a good coat of that, you could probably get away with one coat. Which is actually good for a texture polish, because putting on the second coat is sometimes problematic. And this polish from China Glaze only needs one coat, really. It is. Color-wise, they are virtually identical. You can see how fast that W7 dries down, though. it's almost dry already. But yeah, colour-wise, they are super-duper similar. Next, look at these two here. Two Aussie brands battling it out. So, from BYS, we have Amethyst Metallic. And from Ultra 3's Gel Look line, we have Peacock Purple. Now, in all honesty, their Gel Look line is not any different, really, from their other line. It just costs more money. And it has a much smaller range of colours. So, the BYS Amethyst Metallic is a little bit sheer on the first coat. Just a touch sheer. A little on the stinky side. It is an older polish. And the Ultra 3. Much better formula than the BYS, but colour-wise they look completely different. This is very pink-based, but we won't know until we put another coat on. Now, I'm going to compare two Ultra 3s that look very similar in the bottle. We have Lots of Fun and Pretty Purple. I'm pretty sure Lots of Fun's actually darker, but they do look super duper similar. So this one is Lots of Fun. Pretty Purple. On the first coat, they look super duper similar too. I will reserve judgment until I do another coat. Not going to draw any conclusions. Then we have these two here, which are actually kind of similar to the last two. This is Blew My Mind from Rimmel. And from Jordana, which is actually textured, so slightly different finish, is Raging Purple. So, Blew My Mind, which is pretty much a blurple. It always looks way more purple to me than blue, which is why it's in my blue and purples and not in my blues. And just on that first coat, I can tell this is like a completely different colour. They kind of look a little similar in the bottle, but it might just be too hard to tell with the wrapper that's on the... It Blew My Mind is actually closer to the last two that I actually swatched. So, yeah, these two aren't going to be alike. We'll go on to the last little grouping. So, the first one, it's in two bottles because this is Let's Talk from Sinful Colours. When I bought my bottle of Let's Talk, this is how the brush came. So I transferred as much as I could into this other bottle. So this is actually Let's Talk from Sinful Colours. I'm going to compare it to this one, which comes from the main supplier I use for my acrylic stuff. This has been B Nails. They don't name most of their polishes. This is just B278. Then we have from Crabtree and Evelyn. This is called Cobalt. Looks really great in the bottle, but if I remember rightly, it's got kind of a sheer formula. And lastly, This is probably a bit darker than the others. This one is Marin Ho from Maybelline Colour Show. Main reason I'm comparing this one as well is because it has a similar kind of shift to it. So we will start with Let's Talk. The brush that I, the polish that I replaced it with has a really crappy brush, but at least it has a brush. This is actually funny because it looks a lot more like that Rimmel than I was expecting, just without the shimmer. So that's Let's Talk. Next we will do 278 from B-Nails. Which looks a lot cooler, especially on the first coat. I'm going to put on a bit of a thicker coat because its formula is a lot thinner. But you see it's warmer than the Sinful Colours. And then the Crabtree and Avalon. Crabtree and Avalon are one of those brands that look amazing in the bottle and just doesn't perform, quite frankly. Oh, this one's better than I remember. I take that back then. It is a lot closer to Let's Talk. But Let's Talk seems to have a much stronger shift to it, more pinky shift, but it's only first coat, so we'll see. And Marin Ho from Maybelline. It's actually really blue in comparison. A lot bluer than I remember. There you go. Doesn't look blue in the bottle, it definitely looks purple in the bottle. Alright, so I will go back to my... Whoopsie. Sorry guys, whacked you again. Alright, so we have Purple Passion from Ulta 3. Which in comparison to the ones I've just watched, looks like pink. It's still super duper beautiful polish. And Instant Iris from Sally Hansen's Insta Dry line. As I said, the shimmer ones do need two coats. They just don't work otherwise. So, the Sally Hansen is much brighter, more pink to it, less purple to it than the Ulta 3. So they're not alike. They're similar, they're not alike. So Plum Motion from Maybelline, Express Finish from years and years ago. Gosh, that looks good. I should pull this out and wear it more often. Such an interesting colour. Formula is still great for a polish that is as old as that one is. And Opal Purple from Designer Brands. Put on a really thicker coat because it's one of those ones that probably needs three thin coats. Okay, so base colour wise, the base colour is very, very similar. So in that vein, they do look very similar. The Maybelline has a more pinky kind of shift to it. The Opal Purple has much more purple shift to it. But other than that, they are very similar colours. I prefer the more purpley type shift, but the formula on the Maybelline one absolutely knocks the Designer Brands ones, like, for six. It's just amazing. So next we have Mauve Suede from W7, which really probably doesn't need a second coat, but I'm going to put it on anyway. and Harmony from China Glaze. Not really the same. It's not just a textural finish type thing. The colours are a little different. Interestingly enough, it's probably the China Glaze is probably closer to these two over here. That is Polar Purple and thank God it's Friday from BYS, and Polar Purple is from Sally Hansen. That's probably closer to those ones. The colours are very similar. Yeah, they are similar. They're not the same, but they are similar. And, you know, it's not just a textural thing. I think if you put, like, a shiny top coat on this, they'd probably look a lot more similar, quite frankly. Yeah, they're very similar. W7 one is just, in some ways it's more versatile because you can either wear it matte or you can make it shiny. So, yeah, personal preference thing. So, we have Amethyst Metallic from BYS, which is a lot sheerer than I remember it being. Another one that looks like it needs multiple coats. It's pretty, but it just, the formula's not great, clearly. I have lots of polishes that are very similar to that, which you would have seen in my last swatch video. And Peacock Purple from Ultra 3. It's much darker in colour, especially on the second coat. The shift is a lot stronger. It's it has more in. I have some other colours in my collection that are very, very similar. So it's in those same vein as the kind of purple, pinky purple with a shift to it. So yeah. These two are probably not that alike. The Ultra 3 is much darker. Packs a bit more of a punch. I'd probably go with the Ultra 3 one. So the two Ultra 3s looked very similar. Lots of fun. Pretty Purple. Wow. Yeah. In person, lots of fun is ever so slightly darker but brighter, if that makes sense, and Pretty Purple is slightly more muted. But yeah. They're very, very similar. This is not the first time you've seen me show you Ultra polishes, Ultra 3 polishes, which are very similar to each other, because it happens a lot. Yeah. So, yeah, probably don't need both of them. Am I going to get rid of either of them? No. But, yeah. If you didn't have either of them and you wanted to pick one, well, it depends on whether you want it slightly darker or slightly more muted. But there you go. They are basically the same polish. Basically. Yeah. So, we have Blew My Mind from Rimmel. Which is not applying very nicely. On the second coat, to my mind, it ends up looking a lot more purple than the first coat. Clearly, it is not going to be anything like Raging Purple from Jordana. I think the only similarity I saw is actually more from the wrapper than anything else, because they don't look anything alike. Hey, you can have some duds occasionally. Okay, so let's talk from Sinful Colors. It's a beautiful color. Lots of people I know like Let's Talk. Beautiful, beautiful color. Kind of like the shimmery version of Blew My Mind, really. The number B278 from B Nails is nothing like it, even though it looks like it in the bottle, which is like really super weird. It would probably benefit from being put over a darker polish, I'm thinking. Let's grab my black swatch wheel. Yeah, so it does look very blue when you do that, but clearly it performs better over a darker polish. So if you put it over a purple, you could get more of a purple look with the blue sheen, because, I mean, unless you kind of like that lighter kind of look. So, yeah. Just for interest's sake, anyway. Crabtree and Evelyn Cobalt is much more like Let's Talk. There is a shimmer difference between them. Like the size of the particles. But other than that, color-wise, they are like super-duper similar. Obviously, the Sinful Colors is actually a cheaper polish. Crabtree and Evelyn polishes are ridiculously expensive. Especially for the quality of some of them. And Marin Ho from Maybelline Color Show, which for some reason I can't get the lid out of the bottle. I hadn't even closed it and couldn't get the lid out. So it has a similar kind of shimmer to it, but the color is a lot bluer. But there is a similar kind of shimmer going on in there. It's actually a really beautiful polish. Even if it is a bit more blue than the others. So the Crabtree and Evelyn Cobalt is actually very similar to Let's Talk. It's just the shimmer's a bit different. The shift, it's got a slightly more blue shift to it than Let's Talk. Let's Talk really just has like a purple, like it's just shimmery, but it's not like shifty. Like, Cobalt's, like, shifty, and B278 is shifty, whereas this is just shimmery. Yeah. So, yeah. That is it for part three of my comparisons of my purple polishes. If you want to see more of my stuff, then click the subscribe button down there. Leave me a thumbs up if you like Nail Polish Type videos, and leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments, and I'll see you in my next video. See ya.